Hey everybody, it's day, I don't even know, but it's morning again, and we're gonna go get at it. What are we doing today? I have no idea. Let's pull up our board here, take a look. We had a good day yesterday. Built some awesome, let's pull that up real quick. Don't you think? Got to do some cool shuffleboard brand stuff, oh yeah. I think it was pretty successful. I think we got some really cool stuff done. I had fun, that's for sure. You could probably tell. And there's just a lot of raw material here and direction that I think is cool. All right. By the way, I'm kind of getting used to these video camera morning sessions. I feel like these make me really nervous before I go on this camera stuff. Now I'm still kind of nervous and definitely awkward, but I'm getting used to it. I'm getting used to having a camera in my face every morning. It's weird. What's in our backlog right now? Type samples. We did that. We were really working on design, web, app, book, and feel. Okay, this, I'm gonna say, design is like a thing that's always gonna be happening. I'm gonna say code, basic, web app look and feel, that'll help us know that this is actually the implementation of the style guide and the stuff we checked off yesterday in the code. So we got a little bit of a grab bag of some things we really got to do here today. This is important. I haven't really decided if I want to do this now or wait until I have one more interview before I make a bunch of changes. Maybe we'll go back and look at Jason's interview and decide. This would be really cool, real-time stuff, real-time database. I want to do it. Is it necessary for our meeting? This is good stuff. Oh, two-dimensional grid. That was a good one to add. That is not, it's not for now. Do I have sorting cards? Should have, you know, there should be drag and drop, I think it was like React D&D. Or whatever. But that was really hard for me to figure out last time I tried to look at it. Yeah, they gotta be able to shuffle it. Gotta be able to shuffle. I don't even know if I want to do that one. I went all the way down to maybe. There's a few things in here, like the admin owners. So here's the thing, like we want to get these rules down. I want to get things secured. In a lot of ways, just because I can share these videos more widely, if that's kind of locked down. Securing, okay, what is the issue here? Like basically need to, depends on how we structure our orgs, our organizations thing, which is, okay, so there's like a double dependence or a dependency. Does that, can I just do that? Subtask, dependencies. Ooh, if I was pro, I could. Depends on how we structure. So if we do these organizations, that's how we want to build this thing that says users live in an organization. So that's just got to live with this guy. Because once users live in an organization, we can build rules based on those organizations. Because that's how the rules should really be. It shouldn't be like, did you make the card? It should always be, are you a member of an organization that the board the card lives on belongs to? That's a bit more complicated. Uh, I don't know if we need that here. That's probably before launch, though. Be good to get some ideas. This is a kind of a long list here before private beta. I think there's like a separate, there's like a section here called big purchase. There's like a purchase milestone. Things that need to happen before people can buy this thing. Excuse me. If somebody's gonna buy it, they need to be able to get help. This isn't just a bonus. Facilitators construct, that's a bonus. If they're gonna buy it, we need a terms of service. Probably, well, maybe not, we'll see. If they're gonna buy it and use it, so if they're gonna buy it, they're gonna use it. If they're gonna use it, we need Google Analytics. I'm not, that could go either way. Obviously the purchase itself, new users can see an onboarding checklist. But this stuff is kind of more related to purchase. Because if we don't have people purchasing it, then it doesn't really matter. Can't see other people's answers until time is up. I'm not sure if this is the right thing to have a separate section here, because I'm not even sure what order it needs to appear in. Like, if it's a private beta, are we giving it to them free, or, you know. That sort of helps me sort them a little bit. I feel like I say this in most videos, but it's kind of a slow start this morning. It's okay. let's just open up our code editor and play around with a couple of these ideas. Maybe we'll take a couple low-hanging fruit to get warmed up, and then hopefully we can tackle some of the bigger things there that I think are really just it's time to get going on. PM start. Okay, human-readable dates with moment. That's an easy one. Let's do that first. All we gotta do is on our list of boards. Just wanna do moment here. Can we do like yesterday and stuff? Calendar time, yeah. So board created on is a Firescript date object, so we're gonna turn it into JavaScript and then pass the JavaScript into moment, which doesn't exist. Oops. Well, let's make it exist. It's running, it's done. filed successfully. Oh.
That's nice.
Okay. A little warm up. Sometimes you just get in and you just want to work on low-hanging fruit all day. And that's the beauty and the annoyance of these backlogs that are prioritized by importance. They don't really let you. They can cheat a little bit, but eventually the important stuff is just going to be at the top all the time. And if you keep cherry-picking down here and saying, well, I'm going to work on my social media, then that's actually not easy for me to do, but you know what I mean. Like, just gotta do the stuff that it tells you to do. All right, this is a little bit bigger, but still, I think, kind of a pretty easy one. This whole app page is really not really... I guess it's still useful. We just haven't had that many things in it. So instead of boards, we're gonna have board. Board. Don't need this. We're out of board. Just one board. We don't need your auth, I don't believe. Just looking for one document. That's actually not how that's going to be. I mean, what is this? What is this page? This is a page that's going to show, excuse me, a board when they click it. So if you go to router, let's do that first. Boards. So there's, now it's basically like present mode, except we're not showing it in slides, we're just showing it in report. So this is like the live mode, live stuff. Just basic app stuff. And this will be like miscellaneous. Because this is like a private thing we have, and this is like just the home page. I guess you always have to have that at the bottom. Okay, I'm with it. I'm with it, people. So if you go to a board/board ID, we're gonna send you to a report about that board. Yes, we are. Where are we? Boards. Board ID, board. So now this is gonna get it. It's gonna get the stuff. It's gonna have a match. Do we need a history? There's probably a whole bunch of stuff we don't need in here. So it's really match dot, what is it, params. I never really remember what the... That's not where you need to do that. We'll just see what happens. Can I do this? Probably not. That's a terrible idea, I'm sure. Okay. So yeah, it should be an app layout. Templates wrap. Yeah, we don't want to show all of our templates. Not that. I don't know that we need any styles for this yet. It's really just a H2 situation. We do need the list of all the slides. What is that? Cards. So look at this, we're going to do change my mind, this is going to be board container. It's only going to load things, that's its only job. Now we get to the real one. We do want our moment here, probably. We don't need this. We don't need this. To do. Make this work. Like an H1 at this point. Board container, board slides. So when you click a board, you actually, so we could go to the URL of a board, but we don't want to have to do that. We want to click on a board. So when you list, see all the boards, present, you know, presenting is okay, but we really just want to do boards now. And then, what was that, present? On the board, maybe we can have a button that says, see what happens. Okay, you're in shuffle board. Go to click on one of your boards. The whole app breaks. Cool. That's what I wanted.
Not really.
Oh, yeah. So, this whole match thing. I forget how to do it. I have to look it up every time. Let's see how I did it other places. Board container had a match. Oh, that's what we're using right now. Join has a match. And how do they use it? Match params board ID. Oh, it's not a query param, it's just a param. That's probably why I get confused. Map of undefined slides. It's not getting any slides. Well, let's just see if it works without that part. So, like, yeah, you can click a board and it'll show you when it happened, and you can even go to the presenter view for that board. Or not. Interesting. Oh, board/present, that's why. That's what we want. How many other places do I do that? I just do it this way. So yeah, you can present it. Cool. So now we gotta show the slides. It's not slides, it's cards. Slides are in the board already. We just want to say for each slide, we just want to say H2. Slide prompt. Oh, we got to do something with our cards. How are we going to get our cards in here? Oh, the simplest way would be to do something evil like this. Cards. Dot filter. Evil. What is the content? Do we have any content for this? What was good? What was not good? Oh, it didn't. Let's get one where we have real stuff. Oh. It works. We don't show like count on here. That is because we'd have to get all the likes for each of these items, and we should probably just do that. Maybe this is where writing real SQL would be useful. Yeah. All right, how do we do that for our card? You know, we could just show the card here, but then we have to have conditional about whether you can like it from here and stuff. We don't really want to do that. Excuse me. I do need the card author. Yeah. Maybe we should just show the cards. All right, let's do that. Card with presenting. Why not? What else does it expect? Just a card? Wants to be in a card wrapper or a cards wrapper. Seen worse. Got the author, the number of likes. Let's just pass it a no reactions flag. And then when we receive a card, if there's no reactions flag passed to it, we don't have to show the reaction. So if there's not a no reactions flag, do that. So you can't do anything with these cards, just shows them. But if we were to present this board, we could react. When I hit present, hit my X, went back to boards, and it's a little bit not what I wanted. I have to think about that. There we go. That's probably good. It's still doing it in its parent deal, but that's fine. All right. What have we done? We updated and added a new route for viewing a board report. We have a new board and board container view. We used to have boards, but we changed them to other stuff. Do we still call those other things boards too? Oh, this is going to be a lot to look through. Yeah, we kind of do. Wrapper, and I want to be board list wrapper. And board wrapper, I want to be board list item wrapper. it'll still work. What else are we using? Board. What else does that mean to us? So the board is like the report itself. I mean, should we call it report? No, I don't think so. Yeah, this should be presenting. So we just did some typo or just some cleaning up of our names, keep things sorted. We don't have to remember, you know, things should be called what they are. We're just sort of filtering that, figuring that out as we go. Okay. One more thing I want to do before I commit this. This presenting thing. Yeah, we'll do it later. And another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey. Hey. Doom, 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 doom. Another one bites the dust. Down, boom, chicka, boom, chicka, boom, chicka, chum, 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 chum. All right. That's another low-hanging fruit, but we can't do that forever. We've done some good low-hanging fruit for the first half hour today. Let's come back and just work on this organization concept. We'll just think about it. And if we get stuck on that, we'll just go and review Jason's interview or something. Or maybe I'll come back in a second and just decide I want to do something completely different. Okay, back in a minute. Hey everybody, I'm back. I made myself some orange slices so that I could eat and wake up a little bit. It's probably not gonna be the most pretty thing to watch somebody eat orange slices on camera, but that's the fruit that I have today. So just like, think of it as like ASMR or something. That's just what the deal is. Okay, I'm not even sure I'm gonna eat those. It's just gonna be a mess. So here's something. When I'm working on a project, the pattern I really like to do is to write code and do design in the morning. And then in the afternoons, I go through this backlog, I reorder things, I do research about the things I want to work on. I read through a lot of documentation about what I'm going to be building. And so that way, the next morning, I'm ready to work on it. But I'm not doing that for two reasons here. One is this is project is living alongside other work that I do. So if I'm spending the morning doing this, I'm spending the afternoon working on other important projects for clients or something. The other thing is that I'm committed to doing this whole project on video. So if I just browse documentation and don't record it, that doesn't really, that's a lot of work that I'm doing on the startup that isn't part of this project, and that would be bad. So I'm just gonna remind myself of that, that that's the pattern I chose, which means there's just gonna be some reading of documentation in these videos, probably a fair amount at this point because we're about to get into another area of these Firebase rules that I'm not super familiar with. So, you know, that's what it is. So here's the deal. Pull up that old sketch. Excuse me. We had a little, should I just pull up the one we have from before? Do, it's sketches. new. Did I not save that thing? Oh, I know where it is. Sorry, it's embarrassing. It's in my folders from the, which I don't remember what day it was. I don't really want to go through that all right now. Basically, we got a couple objects. We got things like users. Can we not do this? Okay, look, we got users. They got boards. Boards have cards. Now, the way we know whether or not you can mess with boards and cards is whether or not they're connected to a user right now. But the problem is that in database speak, this boards to users is a many-to-many relationship. I'm just a little slow today. And what this little crow's foot dealy means is that users can have many boards. That's fine, we already knew that. So if you have a board, you just figure out which user it's attached to. Boards can also have many users. So how do you figure out what user is attached to? If you're trying to figure out if somebody in the world should be able to see a board, how do you figure out which user it belongs to? Who does it belong to? Multiple people, if everybody participates? Who is the one, you know, if somebody gets a subscription to this thing, how do we know what boards are theirs and how do they transfer them? The way to do it, IMO, is we're going to make something called organization. Organization is just like your team. It could be called a team. It could be called whatever, but it's just that basically this thing's going to be the thing that has billing, etc. So then this doesn't exist. Instead, what you get is every board lives in only one organization. So yes, organizations might have many boards, but each board only has one organization, sort of like this. That's a little symbol I learned about how to do that. And users, this is going to still be many to many. We have to figure that out. And I think I might have like a thing called a membership here to track who's in what. And so if we have this stuff, this is going to have to be figured out a little bit. But this is going to be nice because it's going to mean that we can always figure out the owner of the board is the organization. And then what we have to really determine is what is the relationship of the user to that organization. So for example, in human speak, if I were to want to see a board, what I really want to say here is this: allow if the user is a member of the board's parent organization. That seems like a simple enough thing to say. There's a lot of lines going between there, but it makes sense. That's for reading. What about for creating a board? Allow if the user is, we might say, for example, or how about for delete? Whatever. Let's say for create. Allow if the user is an administrator, for example, of the board's parent organization. So this is basically going to just say you actually have to be a member of a certain type to be able to do this stuff. That might come later. Maybe not. I think, you know, when it comes to cards, it's funny, like, if you write a card, you should be able to invite anybody to a board, I think. Like, you should be able to write and invite anybody to... I don't really mind if people add or remove their own cards to any board. If they happen to know the board string, that's kind of on... That's like a obfuscated sufficiently. They're not destroying anybody else's data. They're not reading anybody else's data necessarily. Although they could read it if they have the piece. I'm really worried about destroying data and listing data. So this get and list stuff we have to think about. So let's just look up some Firestore rules. Speaking of documentation, I think there's a thing where you can make a function in a rule that makes it so that this stuff is a little bit more repeatable. I'm going in. Okay, know this part. Know this part. I don't know, guys. Okay. Yeah, this is where we need to start reading. Oh, my phone died again. All right, hold on. Hey, I'm back. This phone stuff is so annoying. It's just like filling up and I don't know why. It's a good though, because it gave me the chance to eat those orange slices off screen. I feel like it just makes you look like a Saint Bernard or something. Like you're in it. But I also found this, check this out. This is the mug I was drinking out of yesterday. Guess what's on it? The grid. Did we even talk about that? And my water bottle is like Big Blue, which is like a theme yesterday. I'm working on these functions. We got to read through these Firebase function stuff. Let's take a look. Custom functions. Okay. I want to level with you guys right now. Custom functions. Hold on. Yeah, like this stuff where you can write custom. Okay. I don't want to do this right now. I don't want to work on this. It seems annoying. I just don't want to do it. I just don't. It's just, I mean, you saw me yesterday. It was really fun. We got to do branding stuff. That's like what I like. I like doing that. I like building products. I don't love reading documentation about, databases. I don't like it. That's okay. We'll keep doing it. Let's figure it out. Get through it. Bite-sized pieces. We'll get there. Okay, custom functions. So you can basically define... Where is the function? Okay, function signed in or public. Yeah, okay. If, okay, that's cool. Well, it's so simple. You just write it. It's not that bad. Filters. Yeah, we figured that out earlier. Okay. So what if we lived in a world where we had a, let's get our emulator booted up. Well, let's just write the test first. So what if we lived in a world where, what did I change in this one? Why am I doing that? What if we lived in a world where there were these organizations? Let's rewrite these tests accordingly. For example, it's kind of confusing. I want to just put this down here. You know? This should be a separate item entirely. Makes no sense, but whatever. Okay. So how do we know that this, why will this one, why should this one succeed and why should this one fail? Well, because Matt Alice is a membership to the first one. So there's a thing called Alice. I'm not sure she's even going to be able to do this according to the rules we have, but maybe if it's not in here, they can do whatever, we can do whatever we want. Okay, so this will definitely fail, but let's run it. Or at least if it fails, that's a fail too. So something, it's not going to go well, but let's just do it. Don't you think we should make this like a thing? Oh yeah, okay, only one failed. User, logged in users can create a board if they belong to the board's organization. So everything's passing except for the one we just wrote. Okay, so now let's write a rule to actually make this work. If, press start. How do these functions, do they have the, oh, they have the context of everything. That's cool. So let me try this. Can I abstract these all into a function? What am I gonna call it? I forget what the difference between these is right now, so. So we're just gonna throw it in here and realize, look, what is update. Yeah, why are these different? That's it. That's cool. Let's try that. Hey, most passed again, so that's working. That's so much more convenient. Let's do a couple intermediary commits just to clean this guy up. You know, that's different. So in the Firestore rules, we have some comments we've changed. We're tweaking our rules here. But what we really want to commit right now is just use functions. So let's go back to these rules. Let's write a rule. Okay, boards create. And if created by user, and user user is an org. We need to get we need to get the admins. Ooh, but there's not like a where or anything. I hope I don't have to go back to this whole nested shit. Firebase. Killed me. Is can I only use a path? Both expect fully specified document paths. I do this. Okay, we don't need a membership. We would have to query memberships. We'd have to query all these memberships, okay? That would be the SQL way, but maybe we don't need to query memberships. Maybe we just have an array in the org of people who can deal with that org. So we can get by the org ID this thing. We'll do this. get databases, database, documents, organizations, request dot is create by user. Request.resource.data.organization.id. So get the organization, and then we're just going to be a subcollection called dot members. I think I'm going to have to do this. Exists. Maybe I can make it a subcollection of the org. So then it is going to be exists. God, this is long. Organization ID. So this is all going to go inside now. All right. So this way we wrote this test doesn't work anymore. Now it's got to be if we know what they're in, we know their user ID. I guess that's, we still want that level owner. Let's try that. Let's just see what happens. Doesn't look great. More are failing now. So, let's ignore this one for now. I mean, that's what I want to do. Should this be one test? Board, Alice, Organization ID, Org 1. Assert fails. Permissions is not denied. False for create. L25. Line 25, which line is that? So it starts at 54. So is it like 55? Here-ish? Okay. Let's get rid of the failed conditions. See how far we get. Still don't do it. Will it fail if I don't even do this, but I try to set like this? Just curious. It will not fail. Okay, good. So this is the thing that's breaking. I'm trying to add a board. Alice is trying to add a board. Created by Alice. With the organization ID of org 1. Now, org. Maybe that typo was just it. Let's see. Looks like it wasn't. Yeah, still failed. Okay, so there should be a thing in organizations. Let me see if this is even working. Won't work. Because we don't have any organization stuff. So do we need to create all the stuff around organizations for this to even work? magic allow statements. Oh, members. Maybe I need to do that. Oh my god. I don't know if you can see it because where my face will be, but 10 passing. So this kind of worked. Well, didn't work. Let's try to actually test something. Okay, it works. You can add boards if you have the org thing going on. The real question is, will it break if you don't have the permission? Because you're not in the, because you're creating something that's not your board by created by, yeah, it will break. Now here's the real one. Will it not work if you're not a member of the org? It passed. Was getting dark there for a minute, guys, because I didn't know if this shit was going to be realistic. I'm glad we're working on this because the whole app hinges on this working well. Okay, this is good stuff. Wait, I don't need this. Okay, so Alice user. Let's just run real quick one more time. See if I broke any of it. Nope. Okay. Great. Maybe it should just be simple as that. Okay guys, this is exciting. So this needs to not be the case. User is an org. Need another one is user is org admin. And then we can just say this. Org member, and instead of exists, we're actually doing to do get their thing request. Dot level This is the worst line of code I've ever written, you know? Maybe I can just do this. hear about that in a minute. So you can read things about an organization. If database. Really, it's just a. How do you get these to inherit? Why am I copying and pasting this function? Because request.resource.data.organizationID isn't a thing. I can just do this. That's real silly. It's the same except this is this. So cards, if you have access to a card, I think you have access to a card. I just don't want you to list. I'm gonna have to figure this stuff out in a minute. Maybe the simplest thing to do would just be to make it so when you join a board, you have to request access. As a participant. I'm gonna get going in a bit here, but I just want to get to the point where I have enough understanding about this that I can just think about it and let it sit in my brain so that by the time I come back to it later, I'll be, you know, more ready to work on it. Really, the question is like, the question is around obfuscation versus like more security. This is probably where Firebase really starts to break down and just is crappy. Maybe someday we'll have to get rid of it. I don't like the way these functions work. I want to be able to pass parameters. Can I not do that? It does take zero or more arguments. Okay, I can do that. So, that's so much better. I'm not sure these are better. If that's okay. User is org member. User ID, organization ID. Now we need to pass these user IDs. We don't even actually need these, because this is always going to be the same. We just need to pass how it's supposed to know what the org is. So if it's create, it's this. Update, it's just resource.data.organizationID. So what is this for? City. Document name. Which is the ID. So I guess I can just do this, huh? So you can get any user. You can't list users. Create if you are creating yourself. You can update if you're updating yourself. Organizations. You can read if you're a member of the org. You can write. What is it? Create, update, delete. I'm going to say nobody can delete them right now. You can update an organization if you're an admin. You can create an organization. This is the tricky part. You got to be able to create an organization if you're not an admin of that organization. Because you're not an admin of anything yet because you haven't created it yet. So, create if that and let's say this. You can create any organization as long as it says created by you. Because you can't update members unless something else is very specific. You can't update unless you're an admin. You can't delete at all. You can read if you're a member. Create is pretty permissive. You can create any organization, but here's the deal. You can't update members unless there's some very specific circumstances. You can delete members if you're an admin. You can update the membership if you're an admin. You can create members if you're an admin, or is adding their own membership to a memberless org. You have to define that. just save this for now. If for now, we'll just say, if you made it, simple as that. Just being explicit about these verbs, so I know we're covering all these use cases. No need to update. For now. We haven't run any tests in a while. Let's see what happens if we do. Missing if before conditional expression. is going to be pretty bad, probably. That's not bad. Okay. So users can create a board. All right. So what is our board create situation? If user equals... So maybe we just need to update our test here. Users can create a board. Is that the one that failed? Users can create a board. So we broke the one we had just written. We should break this out into multiple tests. But for now, we'll just do this. Oop. See where it's breaking. Still breaking. So you know what? It might be this part here. Because this is no longer something Alice can just do by herself, now that we've written better rules. Yeah. Oh no, shit, it worked. So how does this rule emulator work? Firestore rules emulator. That's one click away. I should have just clicked here. I wonder if this will make a difference. Might be the better way to do it. Admin app.collection is not a function. That's because we didn't do this. Okay. So this users created board is still failing. How do we keep? Didn't work. Oh, it did? Wait, what? Okay, that worked. There's still an issue. What is this? Cards. It wants me to have a catch. I don't know if I want a catch here. Whatever. So that's working, but this isn't. Okay. Ooh, this recording is really long. I gotta stop. This is all in progress. I'm gonna leave it here. We may have to pull it away for tomorrow and just branch it and work on it as a separate item. This fireboard, like, it's amazing how much of our work here is just messing with these freaking rules. These Firebase rules. We have to write a lot more tests too. So let's just look at where we are. This is something I want to do. This is in progress. This is in progress. I might be trying to take off too big of a bite right now. This is in progress, kind of. Shoot marketing video. I might want to do that sooner than later because I might want to do it while I'm not traveling. Let's just make a branch for this real quick. Forget how to do that. It's just like branch dash, git checkout, be new branch. Okay, so we're on a branch. We have this later. We can just check out master. So I can just do this. And now we're back on our original thing. We can do all the work we want, but we always have that work ready to go when we need it here. Okay, guys, this isn't the most fun work for me. It's probably not the most fun work to watch, but that's fine. I think we actually made some pretty good progress on building functions. We also, today we built like our board. It's not gonna work if I click it. Oh, it does work. We built our board reports. So like we got one good thing that we feel like, hey, this is a part of the app that needed to be built, and we built it. And then we spent a lot of time trying to figure out how these security rules are going to work. I think we made some pretty good progress. It's just a lot slower than the other progress because this is not my area of expertise. But we learned how to write functions in Firestore rules. We wrote some better functions. We wrote some crappy functions, wrote some better functions. We improved how we did tests. And I think we actually have kind of the conceptual model for how this organization's thing is gonna work. So it might just be a matter of writing some more tests and fixing them and making a pass, and then writing just a little bit of code in the app to get it to all fall into place. So that's pretty exciting. I gotta go. See ya. All right, real quick. I wanted to just think about this again one more time. I'm just gonna Google Firestore organization rules, or something like Firestore team rules. Firestore organize database team. I just want to Google and see if people have done this. Oh man, maybe this will be a thing. Like, just got to Google it sometimes. Any collaborative apps allow you to rewrite different parts of time and apps. Right. Wait, how have I not seen this before? Okay. Role-based access control. Right, so they're going all nested. Kind of looks like what we did. Nested functions, that makes sense. Source.data.roles. Okay, so no huge surprise here. The way they're recommending you do this is with the whole Firebase nested thing. Which just is, I don't know. Don't smile. He was smiling. All right. So, what if I did the nested thing? How would that affect everything I've been doing? I just want to see. I would get the cards from the board itself. I could do that. This wouldn't be this, this would be in the org. This would just be get the organization that you're in and show all the boards. Not the end of the world. It's kind of fundamentally hierarchical. So maybe you basically do things that are, if it's fundamentally hierarchical, then you just do it the hierarchical way. Okay, here's a tricky one. Get all the cards. Nope, that's not that tricky because you can just say it would be this Firestore collection. Easy. Oh, phone died again. Guess it just crashed. Hello, is this thing on? Okay. If it dies, I'll just let it die. Card reactions would be nested. So maybe that's the way to do it. I don't know. Just gonna take a note for later. It's a thing now, though. Yeah, I kind of agree right now. Someone hates him.
All right, phone storage filled up again. I gotta go anyway. Maybe this stuff will have some future benefit for me, but I'm not sure. We'll figure it out later.